Okay, so performing a related substances method validation is somewhat critical task and requires a lot of information, knowledge, and skill to map the various concentrations. And when it comes to understanding the concentration levels for linearity and accuracy for the given known impurity, we need to understand the release and shelf life specification for the given impurity. Because most of the times, for API or for finished product, you may have a different specification for impurity at release level and at the specification at the shelf life level. You may have a stringent limit for release specification and the monograph limit for the shelf life specification. And this sometimes, confuses chemists and analysts in understanding the exact levels during the linearity and accuracy study, right? So let me explain you. In case if you have a known impurity as a part of your product specification, how you are going to build very easily the levels for linearity and the accuracy study. So here we go with the calculation now. Let us assume that you have a impurity A as a known impurity. And let us assume that the specification for impurity A, at release level and the shelf life level. So what is the specification for impurity A? Okay, so let us assume that the specification for impurity A at release level is not more than 0.2%. Whereas for shelf life, the limit for impurity A is not more than 0.5%. Now, this is the very first step. We have just understand the limit for impurity A. The next important level is we need to understand the concentration of sample in terms of the ppm. Always prefer ppm concentrations because that gives a lot of ease. And as we already always talk about the concentration in terms of ppm, you will not get confused across the various concentrations. So understand that the sample concentration in terms of the ppm. And let us say that your sample concentration is 1000 ppm. How much it is? It is 1000 ppm. Now this is very important information because against this concentration, against sample concentration, now we are going to calculate the limit of impurity A in terms of ppm. Or we are going to understand what is the concentration of impurity A at 0.2% in terms of ppm. And it is very easy to understand. Just understand the 1000, the 0.2% of the 1000 ppm. And that becomes now 2 ppm. Do you understand this? The 0.2% of 1000 ppm becomes now 2 ppm. So we actually got the concentration for impurity A at release specification is 2 ppm. Similarly, you can also calculate the concentration of impurity A at the shelf life specification. And now, this is very important information to build the concentration levels across linearity, accuracy, or even for the precision study. Fantastic. So let us understand that as per the protocol, you need to perform the linearity study from the LOQ to 150%. What is your range of the linearity? Linearity needs to be performed from LOQ to 150%. Now here is important information. See, the LOQ being your lowest possible point in the linearity study. Now what is the highest possible point? It is the 150%. Now in this case, the highest possible point, that is 150%, must be calculated against the highest specification concentration. And just look at this figure. The 2 ppm is the release specification and the 5 ppm is the shelf life specification. So which concentration is the highest one? Is it the release or shelf life? Obviously, it is a shelf life. So you need to calculate the 150% of the concentration in the linearity by considering the shelf life specification. Now this is the first important guidance. Let us assume that you are going to decide on to the level 1. So the level 1 is your LOQ. The level 2 is going to, let us say, 50%, right? 50% with respect to release spec. Okay, RA stands for the release spec. The level 2 in the linearity study, the level 3 in the linearity study is going to be, let us say, 100% with respect to release spec. RA stands for the release spec. Level 3. Now, we need to understand, if I go up to 150% of the release spec, I will maximum go up to 3 ppm, right? 150% of the 2 ppm will become 3 ppm. But my actual requirement is what? 150% of the 5 ppm. And that will become how much? 7.5 ppm, close to 8 ppm. So what is that level? I need to go with respect to release spec will yield into around 7.5 ppm concentration. And that can be, let us say, around as the 100% gives the 2 ppm. Right, the 100% gives the 2 ppm, then probably the 300% will give me how much? 6 ppm. But still it is less than 7.5 ppm, which is my requirement. So if I go up to 400%, the 400% of the release peak will yield me around 8 ppm. So probably, you know, it may look a little bit weird, but I need to go up to the 400% of the release peak concentration to, you know, to cover the 150% of the shelf life specification concentration. I hope you are clear to this point. So let me understand that. Let me set the level number 4. I will say that the level number 4 will be, for example, the 200% with respect to release peak. Right, the level 4, the level 5 now, not 4, the level 5, I will say 400%. Okay, or let me put one more level here, 300%, 300% with respect to release peak. See, I am calculating the concentrations levels with respect to release peak. You can do either way. You can decide on taking the base concentration level. Either you can take release peak or the shelf life peak. There is no any such boundaries to consider your base level. But now I have begin by considering the release peak as my base levels. Then comes the level number 6 now, and that is going to be now my 400% with respect to release peak. With respect to release peak, this word is very important. Now LOQ, I know that it is definitely going to be unknown at the beginning of method validation, and I need to establish it and then further take into consideration. So how much will be the 50%? How much will be the 50%? Remember, your as such specification level becomes your 100%. So my as such specification level for impurity A with respect to release spec, what is the release spec? Is 2 ppm. So my 50% will be, my 50% will be this 2 ppm into 50%. Will that be correct one? So I am getting 1 ppm as a my first level, second level concentration. What is going to be my 100%? So 2 ppm into 100% going to give me again the 2 ppm. Let us understand that now I need to calculate 200% of the with respect to release spec. So this is my release spec concentration into 200%. Okay. And here we go with the 4 ppm. Do you understand how I calculated it? Just multiply with the 200%. Right. Look into the formula bar. Right. So the 300% will now, the as such concentration at working level into 300%. That becomes 6 ppm. And then last one is now the 400%. The 2 ppm, which is my actual release peak level, into 400%, and I got 8 ppm, right? So if you understand correctly, at the beginning of this building the linearity levels, I said 150%, 150% with respect to shelf life, okay? Shelf life spec, SS spec, becomes how much? As the shelf life spec is 5 ppm into 150% will become 7.5 ppm. So this was my expected end linearity level, or the highest linearity level, or the minimum higher linearity level. If I go beyond 7.5 ppm, it's okay, but I must not end the linearity study below 7.5 ppm. 7 ppm will never be accepted, because my requirement is minimum 7.5 ppm. So setting this limit, setting this higher level is very important, and to set that, I need to understand the highest specification between the release and the shelf life. And most of the times, in case of finished product or API, our shelf life spec is going to be highest one. So understand what is the highest specification in terms of ppm. That becomes 5 ppm in this case, and 150% of this 5 ppm becomes 7.5 ppm. So I need to make sure that at least I am considering and evaluating the linearity from LOQ to 7.5 ppm. And now look at here, 1 ppm is my level 2. Of course, level 1 is LOQ. Then the second level is 1 ppm, then 2 ppm, 4 ppm, then 6 ppm. And finally, the sixth linearity level is 8 ppm. So have I covered the 7.5 ppm? Yes, I have covered it. And hence, these levels are well accepted. So this is a way one can easily understand the linearity levels during the related substances method validation in case of you have a known impurity in the hand. So this is the linearity. Now, how one can calculate for the accuracy? Accuracy is again going to be the same, right? You need to only, these are the levels, right? You need to only select the three minimum levels as per your protocol, or maybe more than that as per your protocol. But the only difference is, in case of linearity, you are going to make the sample solutions or the impurity solutions into a diluent, right? But in case of accuracy, you need to spike in a such a way that the final concentration, the spiked amount, will be, let us say, you need to spike the impurity at LOQ level, and you have LOQ level of, let us say, 0.2 ppm. So make sure that you are spiking 0.2 ppm into a sample solution now, not into a diluent. The second accuracy level is, for example, it is now 100% with respect to release peak. So it becomes 2 ppm. So spike 2 ppm of the impurity A into a sample solution. And for example, if your third accuracy level is now 400% with respect to release peak, then spike 8 ppm of the impurity A into a sample solution. That is the easiest way of conducting linearity and the accuracy. So I hope now you must have understood how easy it is to calculate and understand the different concentrations across the linearity or the accuracy level. The most important point is, you know what, understanding these terms, release spec and the shelf life, in terms of percent, because most of the times the specifications are always given in terms of the percent. So first convert this in terms of the ppm, and to converting the percent specification into ppm, you must have the sample concentration. Without sample concentration, you will not be able to convert percent spec into a ppm spec, right? And once you have converted this into ppm, the specification of impurity into ppm, then the third important step is what? Understand what is the highest requirement in terms of the concentration. And that is going to become what? Whatever may be the level required. Let us say in this case, 150% is our highest level. I have calculated the 150% of my highest specification between these two specification, right? That is 5 ppm is my highest spec, shelf life spec. So 150% of the 5 ppm becomes 7.5 ppm. And hence 7.5 ppm becomes now my minimum higher level requirement. I can go beyond that. Okay, if I go up to 10 ppm, no worry. But I must not go below 7.5 ppm. Otherwise, I will not be able to meet the protocol requirement. And see, I have built now 6 levels. Started from the LOQ, which is the lowest possible linearity level, and then I have built 1 ppm as my second level, 2 ppm as my third level, 4 ppm as my fourth level, the 6 ppm as my fifth level, and the 8 ppm as my sixth level. And you must confirm that, you know. You can see over here, I have met the 7.5 ppm, my higher level requirement. I have gone up to 8 ppm level. Now people have little confusion on this term as well. The 50 percentage of with respect to what has to be made very, very clear. So the 50% with respect to my release specification. So if I just keep 50%, probably you will have confusion with respect to what specification I am calculating the impurity limit, impurity concentration. So understand how to convert the impurity limits from percent to ppm. Understand the highest linearity requirement, and then always consider the highest specification to decide your highest linearity or accuracy concentration. And I'm sure you will be able to map all the concentration very easily. Thank you very much.